I would say I'm a persistent guy. I'm sure others say that too. In fact, most people probably say I'm as stubborn and hard-headed as they come. Not a lot of things come naturally to me, but it's not too often that I will shy away or give up on something. This translates to plenty of different aspects in my life, and thankfully, because of this attitude, it created a new light in my life that I would have never imagined. I'm talking about a girl, one that caught my eye pretty early on. During my early years even, I guess you could say it started as early as 7th grade, when I first asked her to dance with me at the local middle school dance. Pure innocence, awkwardness, and a little bit of naivety. I was bashful and shy, but so was she, and after striking up the courage, I even asked her to be my girlfriend by the end of the night. She wore my football jersey during homecoming week, and I felt like a king. My girlfriend was the prettiest girl in school, but it was short-lived. We ended up parting ways on our 7th grade relationship, and to this day, we still argue about who broke up with who. A couple of years passed, and now we were in high school, where the awkward stage was at an all-time high. Now we were big shots, high school freshmen, but at the bottom of the totem pole. It was homecoming week yet again, and this year everyone was scrambling for dates to the homecoming dance. Nobody wanted to go stag. As you all know, you had to find a date for the sake of pictures. Once again, I tried to pursue the prettiest girl around, with the obvious persuasion from a friend, of course, and sure enough, I found myself on a date with the Emma Burt, blonde-haired, blue-eyed, doll-faced girl that once had my heart in 7th grade. However, that is all it would be, just a date for pictures. No romance was struck up beyond the pictures that were taken by her parents, and we went to the dance and pretty much parted ways for the night. I won't go as far to say as that I chased and chased her. Because of my own ego at the time, I probably didn't want to seem desperate. However, she had my eye, always. I soon began to believe she was too good for me, mostly because she was noticed and sought after by just about every guy at school. During this time, and over the course of high school, our friend groups grew to be extremely close. All of us guys and girls would hang out quite a bit, and during this, I apparently developed the reputation of the sarcastic asshole of the group. Looking back, it was probably a defense mechanism for my own insecurities, or a way to impress her. Either way, it was a definite failure. Anyways, if you think I gave up after that, you were wrong. I asked her to be my homecoming date the next year, and to the next dance, and to the next, and to the next. Over the course of high school, I asked Emma to every high school dance except for one, where I was beat to the chase. I took her to freshman homecoming, sophomore homecoming, junior homecoming I once stayed, which was not by my choice, and then junior prom, senior homecoming, and senior prom. 5 dances total, the only date I ever had, and I'm proud of it. Why? Because it eventually all paid off. By senior year, I actually developed a legitimate friendship with her, where we talked plenty, and we even started to hang out with each other outside of our friend group. That homecoming night, my senior year, she gave me the chance I had long been waiting for. We had a corny kiss, and she was finally mine after all these years. We went strong all senior year, and I was as proud as can be. Not only was this girl the most beautiful thing, but she was as sweet as could be, and she was an athlete to boot. A soccer star, a Shoski national champ. She was a more accomplished athlete than I was, and I loved every bit of it. However, I had my faults. I wasn't always as true to her as I should have been. This girl gave me her all, and I took it for granted. I made some mistakes that I regret to this day. And at one time in the beginning of my freshman year of college, I lost her. I lost a girl that I did not deserve, because she sure as hell didn't deserve to put up with the way that I had been treating her. I took her for granted, and a girl like that did not need to feel that way. I lost my way, and in the process, I watched as a once-in-a-lifetime girl walked right out of my life. It was a coming-of-age moment for me, and it shaped me into a man. I realized that I couldn't let someone as special as she was slip right through my fingers. I went on the chase once again, and this time to prove to her I was worth the trouble, and that I wouldn't be defied by my young, immature stupidity. Fast forward 5 years, and we're stronger than ever. Emma is still my number one, she is my best friend, and she is my rock. We have gone through plenty in the process, and no matter what, we have always made it work. No one has understood me more, and there is not a single person that knows me on a level that she does. I trust her like nobody else, and she's always believed in me, even in the times that I did not believe in myself. Emma has had my back during some of my darkest and lowest of times, and she's also supported me during my greatest moments. Emma has opened my eyes to so many things, and in the process has made me a better person. She has shown me what love is, and she's also taught me to love myself. She's also shown me what hard work is, and she makes me want to be the best version of myself. Not only for myself, but that is what she deserves, the best Connor that I can be. Together, we have made it through plenty. She is my number one, and I can't imagine myself being with anybody else. Nobody has made me smile as much as her. No one has made me laugh nearly as much as she has. Nobody motivates me quite like she does. Her goofy, happy-go-lucky personality, her one-in-a-million smile, and her baby blue eyes still knock me dead to this day. Emma has been the missing piece I never knew I would need, and life without her would feel empty. My heart is full, and full because of my love for her. I know I don't always tell her how much I appreciate her, but if she is going to see this...
I just wanted to let you know, Emma, thank you for changing my life, forever and for better. I love you.